Hey, all my football fans out there. This is Buckeye Vinny coming to you at this beautiful, beautiful Wednesday evening. And I did tell you the other day that I was going to break down the game and summarize the game between the number 13 Wisconsin Badgers versus our own Ohio State Buckeyes coming in at number 3. The game will kick off at noon in the Shoe. Okay, folks. I'm going to start breaking it down by talking a little offense with the Ohio State Buckeyes. In fact, it's not a little offense. It's a lot of offense. This is a team that is nearly averaging 50 points a game, with Justin Field leading the way, 22 touchdown passes, and only one interception. And let me tell you, folks, that one interception really, really jumps out at me, and I'll tell you why. This is a young man that right now nearly has 1,500 yards in passing. He's not throwing little screen passes and little dump-off passes. He's throwing the ball downfield and doing all of that with only one pick all year. I don't know about you folks, but this is Heisman candidate reading all over the paper. Headline, Justin Fields as the Heisman. My opinion. Please comment down below about what you think about Justin Fields. Moving on to the rushing game, my man, Dobbins, is coming in with 947 yards on the ground, 7 TDs, averaging 7 yards a pop. This young man, this has been a 1-2 punch for the Buckeyes all year between Fields and Dobbins. And let me tell you about Dobbins. He has majorly hit the weight room over the offseason. He has increased his speed. He's a power back now. The Buckeyes got it rolling. They really do. Coming off the bench, how do you like this? As a backup back, coming off the bench to give Dobbins a breather is Master Teague, the true freshman. This young man is averaging 73 yards a game with 4 touchdowns. He is the backup, folks. There's some starting running backs that's not averaging 70 yards a game and 4 touchdowns. So this young man is a phenomenal backup to Dobbins. Folks, I'm moving on now to the wide receiver core. We have Chris Olave, who has 6 touchdowns receptions on the season. This young man is, he has it all. He has great hands, great speed. The man is a dual threat. He can catch the little passes and then take it to the house. Or he could just beat his man and just hit the long ball and make a fantastic touchdown catch. We also have KJ Hill coming in, 29 receptions on the year, and actually leading the team in receptions, and he's coming in with 4 touchdown receptions on the year. So folks, right now I covered the offense. I'm now moving on to the defense. I do not think this team's defense is getting enough respect. Folks, I'm going to throw this stat out, and it amazed me when I found out. Our Ohio State Buckeyes is giving up only 8 points a game on defense. They average 4 sacks a game. They're coming in with 28 sacks, and they have 10 interceptions in 7 games. This defense, again, I'm going to say it again, is very underrated. But I'm going to tell you right now, they continue to do what they're doing, we will be the top 4 teams in the playoffs. Bring it on, Bama. Bring it on, LSU. I don't care who's bringing it on. But I'm going to tell you right now, folks, the Buckeyes are the real deal. Moving on to Wisconsin. Number 1, folks, you talk about dropping a dud last week against Illinois. I'm sorry, folks. That was a trap game for them. Why did they lose? I'll tell you why. They were looking after the Fighting Illini game and already looking towards the Buckeye game. They thought they were going to come into the Shoe 7-0 and rank 6. Guess what, folks? They did not. They're 6-1 and ranked 13th. Listen, Badger fans, I get it. This happened to us. Folks, I'm a straight shooter when it comes to Buckeye football, okay? I could be a realist. This happened to us last year against who? I'm trying to forget it. Purdue. Purdue cleaned our clocks in Purdue 49-20. Folks, You never take a team lightly. Sorry, folks, but there's no way we should have lost last year to Purdue, but we did. And it knocked us out of the playoff picture. I hate to say it, Badger fans, the same thing's going to happen to you. You should have never lost to the Fighting Illini. I give the Illini all kind of credit. At best, the Illini is a 500 ball club, but a team could beat any team on any given day. Give you a little stats on Wisconsin. They're coming in averaging 40 points a game. Folks, this ain't going to be no pushover, let me tell you. Wisconsin is a good ball club. They're giving up 7 points a game. Better than what we thought. We're giving up 8. They're giving up a touchdown a game. That's it. Give you a little facts on Wisconsin, folks. Out of the 7 games this year, they've pitched 4 shutouts. That's amazing. So I'm telling you, folks, it's going to be a tough game. You got Jonathan Taylor coming in, averaging 6.1 yards a carry, 15 touchdowns, folks. 15. So let me tell you, they do not pass the ball that often. Okay, they don't. They have Jack Cohn as the quarterback. He's averaging 76% of his passes this year. 76% completion rate. That's phenomenal. Obviously, there's no way he compares to my man Justin Fields. He's coming in with 9 touchdowns and 2 picks. So this is what I'm going to do. I want you guys to comment down below. I am going to give you my prediction tonight on the game, but I'm asking you guys to please comment down below. I want your prediction. Here's my prediction. Buckeyes will win this game. It's not going to be a blowout, folks. Buckeyes will win this game 31-20. In the first half, it's going to be a little slow, but the Buckeyes will turn it on with the likes of Dobbins, my man Justin Fields, Master Teague, and a slew of Buckeye players. Folks, listen, I told you my prediction. Please comment down below. I want to hear from you. God bless. Peace out. Go Buckeyes.